Hello, good morning. We are doing home economics and our topic is care of the hair. Care of the hair. Hair can be naturally oily or dry. Hair can either be oily or it is dry. Oily hair is usually soft, very, very soft. While dry hair is hard and coarse. Oily hair is usually soft. While dry hair is hard and coarse. That's the two types of hair we have. We have oily hair and we have dry hair. And oily hair is soft, while dry hair is hard and coarse. We have things used for care of the hair. Things that will help you take care of your hair. The brush and combs. We have brushes and comb. In our houses, we have brush. It's either we have brush for brushing, for the guys used for brushing their hair, or combs for combing long hairs. Now, this brush and combs is used to remove dirt. When you're combing your hair, you're removing dirt from it. Then we have shampoo and soap. Shampoo and soap is used to wash the hair. You use it, you apply it on your hair and use your hand and wash the roots of the hair. Then pomade and oil. Pomade or oil. Pomade is the same thing as oil. That's why there is oil here. It's either you call it pomade or you call it oil, which is your hair cream, your liquid oil you have at home for to apply on your hair. It's used to rub. It is rubbed on the roots of the hair to keep it fresh and healthy. When you apply oil or pomade on your hair, it will help your hair to be fresh and healthy. It will help it to be easy for you to comb it and remove the dirt from it. But if you don't apply oil or pomade on your hair, if you don't wash it and if you don't brush your hair, if you don't comb it, your hair will be dirty. You will have some infections on the hair. Like here, we have types of hair infections. If you don't take care of your hair, you will have infections on the hair, which is lice infection. Number one infection we have is lice infection, dandruff, and ringworm. We have lice infection, dandruff, and ringworm. These types of infection happens to one that does not take care of his or her hair. Now, we have a photo of a boy that is not taking good care of his hair. And look at him here. Look at this boy. His hair is, he's having ringworm. They said a boy having ringworm on the head. Look at it here. This boy, this thing on his head is ringworm, and it's because he doesn't take good care of his hair. Maybe he doesn't wash it. Maybe he plays with sand and he'll be pouring sand on his hair. Maybe he uses chalk or whatever to put on his hair and he doesn't wash it. He doesn't apply oil on it. He doesn't use soap or shampoo to wash it. And look at how dirty his hair is now. He's having ringworm on the hair. Look at this one. This one is having lice on the head. Look at these white things here. It just looks like this ringworm, but this one is a different one. It has lice on the hair there, and it's chopping off his hair from there. It's chopping his hair. So if you take good care of your hair, look at the appropriate way of taking good care of your hair. Look at the girl. She's washing her hair with soap and water. And when she finishes this one now, she will use comb and pomade and apply the hair and comb the hair neatly, pack it neatly. And that's how to take good care of the hair. Now we have an assignment here. Our assignment here is, how can hair be described? You will tell me how hair can be described. Number two is, mention two things used to care for the hair. Mention the two things you can use to care for your hair. We have named the types of hair infections, you know. I've named the type of hair infections here. So you name the types of hair infections, you know. Thank you. Good morning. We are doing quantitative and we are starting with the smallest first. We arrange the numbers in order. Starting with the smallest first, we arrange the numbers in order. Look at our numbers here. I'm sure we know how to write our numbers from 0 to 1000. Yes, from 0 to 1000. If we know how to write it very well, then we should know the smallest numbers. We should know the numbers that come before the other one and the one that comes before the other one accordingly. Like now we have 506, 503, 505, 504, 502. Which one is the smallest number here now? It is 502. because we will not start counting 506, 503. No, we start from 500, 501, 502. After 502, which other number? 503. After 503 is 504. 505, then 506. Yes. So this other number, 825, 821, 823, 822, 824. Which number will come first? Look at it very well. Which number do you count? Which number will come first among these ones here? It's 821. 821 comes first before 822, 823, 824, then 825. Here, 667, 663, 665, 666, 664. Which number comes first? Which number is the smallest? It's 663. It comes before 664, 665, 666, and 667. Now look at our assignment. Our assignment is very simple. 520, 518, 516, 519, 517. 517. Now you start from the smallest and arrange it very well. 908, 905, 906, 907, 909. You start from the smallest to arrange it in order. 775, 771, 773, 774, 772, 939, 938, 940, 941, 942, 616, 620, 617, 618, and 619, 819, 809, 899, 815, and 815. Write them from the smallest numbers to the biggest number. Thank you. Hello, good morning once again. We are going to be doing social studies this morning, and our topic is food poisoning. Food poisoning. What is food poisoning? Food poisoning occurs when something that is harmful in our food affects us. Food poisoning occurs when something that is harmful in our food affects us. Now, food poisoning has to do with when we eat something in our food, and maybe that thing affects our well-being. It makes us, we are no longer feeling fine, it makes us feel like vomiting, makes us a bit sick. That is food poisoning. Now, we have things that causes food poisoning, which are eating food after being poisoned by flies. When you keep your food, you don't cover it and you go and start playing or you start doing one thing or the other and leave the food open there, flies come and pet it. That food has already been poisoned by flies. And when you go after them to eat the food, you would maybe start having running stomach, your eyes will start, you start feeling dizzy, and you start needing drugs too. So number two is picking things from the floor to eat. When you see things on the floor, maybe you are eating something and it dropped on the floor and you pick it again to put inside your mouth, you have eaten something that is poisoned. Using bad source of water to cook or drink. Most of us comes from places where we use very clean water to cook, and we drink very clean water. So if you happen to go and mistakenly use the dirty water to cook or drink, it will affect you, and that is contamination of food and water. Now we have insects and pests also cause food poisoning when they touch our food. Just like I said, still the same thing with this number one. When you leave your food open, or probably you didn't keep it where, you didn't keep it in the right place you're supposed to be, and insects, just like rats, cockroaches, they are moving about and they are petting all those things. If you go and eat it, then that is food poisoning. Like here we have an uncovered food. Look at it here, and flies are perching around here. If this boy comes here and eats this food, yes, it's going to affect him, and he'll be rushed to the hospital because he will start having running stomach. Look at dirty water. If you take dirty water or you use dirty water to cook your food, it is food poisoning. A boy picking food from the floor. Look at him, he's picking food from the floor, and as he finishes eating it, he'll go and start vomiting. We have symptoms of food poisoning, but that's what we are going to be doing, both the symptoms and the prevention, how you prevent food poisoning. We'll be doing it in the next class. So just read this one and know it very well and get ready for the next one in the next class. Thank you.